Let's now understand the architecture of Spring MVC with a small diagram. The most important part of the Spring MVC architecture is the front controller. What's the front controller? Think about it. Yep, you're right. It's the dispatcher servlet. So the front controller finds the right controller to handle the request. So when we said slash login, so the front controller URL that we gave was spring-mvc. So anything starting with spring-mvc would come to this front controller, dispatcher servlet. Where did we configure that? That's configured in the web.xml. Anything that comes to the front controller dispatcher servlet would look at the subsequent part of the URL. It will look at slash login and it will see if there is any controller which is annotated with the slash login. So it would find a controller method which is annotated with slash login. The controller method would be executed and then the controller can return back which view has to be rendered. So controller would tell front controller which view to show, which JSP should to show. In our case, the view we wanted to show was login.jsp and login controller sent back a string login. The front controller then would make use of the view resolver. So it will go to the views resolver and says, there is something called login. I want to find out what the JSP for this is. And the view resolver would tell the front controller, hey, the JSP that you are talking about is /webinf/views/login.jsp. And the front controller would then execute the view template and return the response back. So this is the complete flow of any request in Spring MVC. So in the example which we created, we configured dispatcher servlet in web.xml. The controller which we used is login controller. The view template we are using is login.jsp. And the servlet engine we are using is Tomcat. We have not created a model yet, but we would create a model very soon. So that's a little bit of architecture of the Spring MVC.